Hello, I'm Scott with Sounds Photography, and today I'm going to go over how I tether in studio. Here you can see we have a laptop in front of the camera. It's probably out of focus, but I do have a laptop in front of the camera. It's got an external hard drive. I can take that external hard drive and take it straight into, after the shoot, straight into the main computer and start editing. It's capturing to the laptop and to the cards in the camera. That's how I have it set up. So I have a backup no matter what. I'm using the original stock cable that comes with the Canon cameras to tether. I found them to be the most reliable out of the bunch. Yes, they're a little short compared to what other ones you can get, but it's the most stable cable that I found. You can go out and buy a little more expensive cables like these here. Every single one of these I've ever got, they've always disconnected in the middle of the shoot. They always failed on me. And for the money that I'm paying, they shouldn't fail at all. Again, I'm not paid by this company, so actually I'm gonna give you my honest opinion. I think they're overpriced, and them not working for me, I think they're junk. So again, other people might have good luck with these. I just never had good luck with these. Throw it out of the way. All right. My main light today is actually a Tita lantern with a CL200 at half power hanging from the ceiling. We have a hair light that's right behind it. That's what is a 33 silver beauty dish from Cheeta Stand with an MS300 set to 1/8 power. We have a Cheeta strip on both sides of me. They are both being powered by MS300s. Again, I find the MS300 to be a fantastic, cheap, inexpensive little strobe. And again, I just leave them hanging in the studio. I just leave them there. I don't care about putting them away, nothing. They just stay there. I just put the cap over the end of it so the bulb doesn't get broke, and that's about it. Here we have our test shooting dummy, which is about 4 feet from this black backdrop. And let's get to shooting. The software I'm using is the original Canon EOS utility software. I've got Capture One, I have Lightroom, but I find the stock original software to be the most simplest and easiest software to use for tethering. I don't have any other fancy screens or anything, so when I take the picture, it just pops it right up on the screen. So that's what I like about it. Again, with Capture One, you can actually do that on two different monitors. So you can actually have the big picture on one monitor and your setup on another monitor. And I think you can do it in Lightroom too. But this way, this, because it does the same as this, but again, there's no importing, so I don't have to import the images into Lightroom or Capture One. With this software, you don't have to import at all, and which I like the best. And I usually use Adobe Bridge over Lightroom and Capture One, because again, I don't have to import. Again, if I'm doing only a few images, I use Capture One. If I'm doing a lot of images, I just go straight to Bridge. So let's shut off all the lights here. So I have A, C, and D channel, because the D channel is a hair light. My main light is always A. My rim lights are always C. B is always my fill light, which we're not using a fill light today. So for this setup, all I had to do was go into my tablet, hit the settings for this setup, and then it transfers straight Bluetooth over to this trigger. If you own the X1 version 2 with the Bluetooth, that's an awesome trigger. The Pro Mark II from Flashpoint is an awesome trigger. Pick which one is best for you, but that Bluetooth feature is the best. So let's take a shot without, got a Canon camera. ISO 100, shutter speed 160, and aperture 8. So let's take a shot with no lights at all. Now the picture will show up on this screen, and again, I'll put that up onto in the video so you can actually see it better than the screen. It's a pure jet black image, nothing, no light. I have killed the ambient light in this room. So let's turn on the hair light. Let's take another shot. Okay, here we're lighting some of the shoulder, top of the chest, a little bit of the nose, but again, we're lighting that top of the hair to separate it from that black background. Let's shut that one off. Let's go to the rim lights and take a picture by itself. Here we can see it's rim lighting the subject, separating it from that black background. Again, when you are setting up your lights, this is the way you want to do it. Once set up the lights at a time, not all three or all of them at one time, you want to break them down independently. So then that way you see exactly what each light is doing to your image. Turn off C, let's turn on A. Beautiful butterfly lighting from the lantern. It's giving me the softer shadow underneath the chin, and it's filling or giving me the shadows in the cheeks. If I was doing with a fill, I would have a pair of seven behind me, and that would be channel B, the throw in fill, but I don't need any fill on this image because it's not what I need. So let's do A and the rim lights together. So main and rim. Let's do main and hair light with shut the rims off. Let's turn the main light off and just turn on the rims and the hair light together. Now let's turn all three of them on. Great image. Now, if I was shooting a certain product, this is the kind of lighting setup I normally would keep, because with this, I can shoot from any angle and the light never changes. If I was shooting 45, where the light is at a 45 degree angle and at a 45, my light's gonna change depending on how I move, because again, the shadow is going to be on one side where it's not on the other side, which is good for some images. But if I'm going around and I'm shooting something that has to be evenly lit, pretty much this is how I do it. Again, I'm using the stock EOS software that comes with the Canon, because again, I find it to be the easiest. I'm using the stock original cable that comes with the Canon camera. I find it to be the most stable. I'm using just a standard laptop with an external hard drive. And I'm using a Kupo 29 on a rolling base as my tether table. And that's how I tether in studio. Again, my name is Scott with Sean's Photography, and thank you for watching. And if you have any questions, please comment in the bottom.